Ladies and gentlemen, this is an address to the people and medias of the world. Allow me to share with you a message. What you take from this message is for you to decide. But we must address some important issues at hand as to who we are and what we stand for. We are simply Anonymous. And before I tell you what Anonymous is, allow me to begin by sharing with you a story of one person who takes the step to becoming Anonymous. This person is neither you nor I, but everyone. It is our brother, our sister, our family, and our friend. This is their story. I awoke today much like any other. The alarm, the slight ache nagging in my back, the random ray of light sneaking through the curtain. Today was just like the last and a precursor to tomorrow. Every day was exactly the same. Wake up, coffee, cigarette, get ready, off to work. Spend all day at work dealing with bullshit I could care less about simply to make a few bucks. Go home, eat, a few hours of my time, bed, rinse, repeat. And this is how today was different. Because today, it hit me. Today I recognize this system for what it is. Absolute bullshit. Today I identified within myself what life should be, rather than what is simply accepted. But why? Why do so many people become so completely dismissive to that tiny little itch deep within their souls that calls out to them, trying to remind them what this life could be? Or perhaps I should further emphasize my belief by saying what this life simply should be. Are we really here to be born into this world, raised as a child and molded into conformity? Taught what is to be normal, how to think, what to say, how to live? We begin our young lives with constant indoctrination under the guise of education, only to grow up with higher expectations from all the garbage society shoves into our minds. Our obsession with idols, entertainment, and celebrities has us chasing unattainable wealth and fame until we finally realize that reality is knocking on our door and it's time to put the suit on and get that dream job everyone's always talking about. And why not? Maybe get a nice house in the suburbs, a nice car, enough money to live comfortably numb to the world around us. Maybe a nice little dog will do too. Yes, I think so. Sony has a new big screen? Why yes, I must have that. Right after I get the iPhone 15. We grow up being told who to be. We become that person we are told what to buy, what to wear, and how to be happy. And if you can't be happy, well, there's drugs to help. Then we get old, maybe buy a home in Florida, and then we die. Is this what we're here for? To be shaped into molds, taught to consume until the day we're put into the ground? My mind raced. Conformity, corruption, apathy, acceptance, oppression, violations of human rights. Millions of people suffering, starving, struggling. But why? Why does this have to happen, and how is this acceptable? Corporate bigwigs are living a high life while they rape the land we all share and steal our way of life. Our cultures are polluted by their preachings of capitalism and consumerism. Do we really even know ourselves anymore? Do you like what you see within yourself? Are you happy with the life you have, the struggle of your daily life and lives of others around you? Can you honestly justify that simply because things are going well for you at this present time, nothing needs to be done to change this world, to end the suffering and struggle of millions? Where has our compassion gone? Where's our passion for life? Fact, almost half the world, over 3 billion people, live on less than $2.50 a day. 3 billion people! At least 80% of humanity lives on less than $10 a day and live in countries where income differentials are widening. 22,000 children die each day due to poverty. And 1 billion live in poverty. That's one out of every two children in the world. Estimated to have reached $1.62 trillion in U.S. dollars, representing a 50% increase since 2001. This corresponds to 2.6% of the world GDP, or approximately $236 for each person in the entire world. The United States, with its massive spending budget, is the principal determinant of the current world trend, and now at 43% of the world total, accounts for just under half the military. Fact, the National Police Misconduct Statistics and Reporting Project, NPMSRP, was started in March of 2009 as a method of recording and analyzing police misconduct in the United States through the utilization of news media reports to generate statistical and trending information. In general, from April 2009 to June 2010, there were 5,986 reports of misconduct that have been recorded. 382 fatalities were linked to misconduct. Nearly $350 billion had been spent in related settlements and judgments. 23% of the reports from 2010 at the time of presentation were due to excessive force. 10.6% were linked to sexual misconduct and officers. And recently, in Dayton, Ohio, a mentally handicapped boy was beaten, tased, and arrested by Dayton police. The lists of injustices and corruption in the world go on and on. And now I ask again, how have we come to accept this? Simply because that is the way it is? If we as humans truly have souls, reason, logic, and compassion, then I say that accepting the unacceptably unjust is less than acceptable. Was this a sudden epiphany that burst in my brain, spontaneously igniting receptors and allowing my thought process to comprehend these matters specifically on this day? No, today was different because beginning on this day, I can no longer accept this insanity simply because that's the way it is. Today I can see the system before me, its gears turning, surrounding us from every angle as the machine swallows us whole. Today I brought my wrench. Today, my heart and soul ignited with the ideas that make me anonymous. Still an individual, I am also many. I am you, and you are me. We are one within our cause. Anonymous is not a group, nor is it a membership. Anonymous is merely an idea, the idea of true freedom, a world free of corruption, oppression, and tyranny where we can live our lives as we see fit and truly be ourselves and be accepted for it. An idea that seeks to defend the freedoms and pursue the prater to the bank accounts of a small percentage of wealthy elite and crooked politicians and government officials. In sharing these ideas and principles, we are all anonymous. We are not who we have been portrayed to be. While some who associate themselves as anonymous may make the personal decision to attack targets through hacking and exploits, being anonymous does not make you a hacker, nor does it mean that you are a criminal. Being anonymous simply means that one shares the values and principles of freedom, the defense of it, and the pursuit for it. We are ordinary people concerned with the state of this world. We are your neighbors, your friends, your family. We are your mailmen, store clerks, business professionals, veterans, and military personnel. And united as this one idea we call anonymous, we desire a change. A change that is for once in the better interest of the people of this world. Through this desire, we have devised what we so simply yet eloquently call the plan. The plan consists of three phases occurring over the course of the next year and will continue from there on. Since the launch on June 15, 2011, we have grown to over 50,000 members strong. Our actions and passion for our cause speak volumes for the sincere and pure motives of our movement. What do we desire? A more promising way of life, free of the constraints society has laid upon us, free of the division, a world with more transparent governments that work for the people instead of against them, where peace officers are serving the people once again rather than the establishment. A world where we can evolve as a world community, end these senseless wars and settle our differences with nothing more than true diplomacy. We wish to have less corporate influence in our countries and in our daily lives. We want to see the return of Main Street and the gradual containment of Wall Street. And most certainly, we desire the ability to control our own economy by removing the powers that have been granted to the world banks. And to sum the many ideas we share into one statement, we desire a world that works together as human beings in the best interest of the people, decided by the people, rather than a world divided by race and nationality that functions solely for wealth and conquest. The phases of the plan are broken down ever so simply and yet complex in their own entirety. Phase 1, assemble. Spread the message and begin educating yourself further on the corruption that takes place within our communities and our world as a whole. Share information and assist each other in developing new ideas for our own lives and our communities to improve the current condition. Phase 2. Organize. Continue spreading the message and education. Begin reaching out into your own community and building the unity and bond to strengthen the cause in your local areas. Learn what you can do to help others around you. Learn compassion and caring for others and ways you can improve the lives of others. Begin planning ways to address the important issues that stand between our communities and a better way of life. Phase 3, mobilize, our efforts come full circle, and we begin to share our dissatisfaction in organized mass unison with those who control the current structure of the system. Mass protests, boycotts, and other peaceful means of non-compliance will be used to set the message straight that we will no longer participate and tolerate this system of servitude. Our unity will be our differences will be our foundation. Our cause will be our offensive, and our dedication, intelligence, and philosophy will be our defense. Change is coming, and we can for once look forward to this change. United as one, divided by zero, we are anonymous. Expect us.